He's doing it for the camera. He's doing it for the camera. He's doing it for the
camera. Good. Come on, one side, guys. We'll run.
Yeah. On the sweepy bit. The sweepy area. No, higher. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah, a bit further back.
So, just a little bit of a forwards review of BAR, first of all, about what they do, I suppose, how we can get after a bit.
What are guards like to work with?
Brilliant. You know, when I first took over back in 2017-18, you know, I suppose I'm fairly reflective. I know what I'm okay at, and I know what I'm not good at. And we'd lost the experience of Chris Davey, a phenomenal coach, but also forward orientated, understands contact area, set piece, and all the sort of things that I definitely know that I can't do. So being able to call upon someone like Ian with the experience he's got, national age grade, Welsh Premiership, would have him in, and somebody I work with as a colleague as well and consider a friend, to be able to work with him every day is a joy. Don't get me wrong, he can be a bit spiky at times, but no, very much enjoy his company.
My name is Ian Gardner. I'm head coach of Cardiff Met Rugby Club, and I'm also an academic lecturer. I'm a senior lecturer in sport, physical education and health.
This is probably your first home start, I believe. Yeah. All right, so you just play your normal game. Yeah. You know, you're an intelligent boy who's got aspirations to go to the next level, but you should be taking ease in your fucking stride tonight and just being again. So I'm looking at going to feed well again. His work rate, his effort, because that's how Mac measures, he work at the physicality. Okay. Simple as that, and he was top draw last week, and it's got to be more of the same this week. Goodbye.
What does like change of focus this year? And we had what we call the Hard Man Showman Award, and you know, the hard man sort of elements go around sort of you know, tackles and contact areas and dominating collisions and that sort of. Whereas the showman, again, you still need hard work and that, but it's sort of, you know, it's key passes, beating defenders, sort of support play, carries, and pretty much the award goes to that person who's really showing up in sort of both categories. So that really shows they're working hard, and we just felt, you know, Lenny the lion, as it were, is a lion is obviously a hard, strong beast, but in it he's got like his mane is sort of multicolored, so he's a bit of a showman as well. So we just felt that toy represented the sort of the Hard Man Showman Award quite nicely, and we make a bit of a presentation in our review every Monday.
It's my personal chef. Paying by the day.
Daf Tuetti, fourth year, marketing, masters, and centre.
Roma Zeng, second year, sports coaching, and I'm a winger. I think it's quite hard to have your own space with six rugby lads, it's like. And like big as well, like most of my front rowers. Well, they're all front rowers, so when we're all in the kitchen, you can't even move. So, yeah, we do sometimes cook for each other, don't we?
Yeah. Well, I hardly cook. I get my chef Nif to cook for me.
Sorry, he never cooks. Everyone seems to. He's like the pet of the house. Everyone just wants to cook for him.
This week on the BUCS Rugby Podcast, we're looking ahead to Bath's next home fixture. They're up against Cardiff Met. They could go three on the bounce against the Archers. It's a difficult one to call this time around, but Griff, what do we think about this one?
Well, Met will definitely be looking to bounce back after the last couple of games. And if they do get it right, they can 100% spoil the party.
Yep, absolutely. Like I said before, it is a difficult call. It would be 3 on the bounce if Bath did pick up the win. But I think this time round, Met might just edge it.
It was good because we knew what we were going to get with Bath. We knew we were going to get a physical set piece, a very up front, a bit of a man's test, a bit of physicality test. So we were quite excited for that challenge.
Bath are here looking to protect their home turf in what we're expecting to be a physical upfront encounter. Met, well, they are looking to bounce back from their home loss to Exeter last week.
Okay, same messages that we spoke about Monday night. I'm sure the coaches will feed into that. We talked about last week, you know, shots fired, didn't put any in against Cardiff Uni. Didn't really put any in last week against Exeter apart from that last 10-15 minutes. All I want to say is whatever happens, let's come off the pitch today and know that you've outworked your opposite number. The physicality you've brought. If every single one of you, 1 to 23, outworks your opposite number, we win today. And for me, it's as simple as that. Okay, conditions are something to be aware of when we go out there. We'll have a little chat about that, just to get a feel for what it's like, although we feel the wind is dropping as the night goes on.
We want to be a university that's, you know, held in high regard and held in high esteem, not only for the play-in, but for the support we get as well. But in terms of the sort of numbers and the noise and the degree of support they can, there's no better. They're all the rugby players within the club, and it's great that they can come to support their fellow players. And at the same time, I'm sure lots of them are inspired by what they're seeing there and want to push up the club.
Met have started strong here with the early score, but now find themselves defending their own try line. Can Bath get over? Are the brothers going to do it? They're over! That is the score! Bradley Roderick Evans is stood over this penalty. He sends it up. He sends it through the post, and with that, Cardiff Met go into the half-time break 10-7 up.
The forward there, a big, big positive has been his end of defence. We've got to keep that fucking going. They put real pressure on them. They're coming back inside again, high on the outside, hard on the inside, and we're almost better without the ball at that time. The other thing that worked really, really well on Crystal Palace Labrador is the ball, but we got for some variation. The first ball was great, the second one when we picked and drove, that was really poor. There's no fucking wedge in there when Tyler got smashed. So we've got the detail has still got to be in there, boys. It's not fucking rush, set it up, change the point of attack, and be fucking physical. So we've got the physical edge on this team.
An early second half scrum here for Cardiff Met. Let's see what they can do with this position on the field. And they get the penalty. It's just what the pack would have been after. Met have got the advantage. They've got the opportunity for a free play here in a crucial area of the park. The forwards taking it up now, eking Cardiff Met closer and closer to that try line. Roderick Evans with the chip over the top of the Bath defence. Joe Westwood soars through the air to collect it and score for the Met. Coaches and players watching on in the closing stages now. It looks like the Met have done it. The fans certainly seem to think so. Roderick Evans looking to finish the second half like he finished the first with yet another penalty. And there it is, a good win for Cardiff Met, back on track after last week here in Bath. The full-time score, University of Bath 12, Cardiff Met 26.
I just like 11:15, which is quite a good time to get a bit of a lie-in. It's nice. We all go as a house, me, Roma, Nathan, a few other boys as well, which is just like 5-minute walk from our house, which is ideal. And then we just go there, sit the service, sing a few songs. And listen to the preacher, and then just come back home, sometimes get a Greggs on the way back, just a little snack. But it's just nice that we all share the same faith and just like have the same beliefs. And it's just good to relate to someone who's like same position, like uni student. And it's just nice to have in the environment.
Is it, you speak to your mum and she gives you, is that Bible verse?
So every Wednesday, she puts a Bible verse in the family group chat, and then I read it before the game and then end up writing it on my tape. It's just like a little reminder to me just to stay connected to my faith and just like help me get through the game. It's just a little ritual I do before every game, and it just helps me just get through the game, really.
Somebody crowds me, Snoop draw his niggas from Crenshaw. Little bit of stop, sit, shit, that ain't not these.
back at Kincoid campus on Rugby One, and it's Cardiff Met versus Nottingham University.
Be on point. Make sure we're talking a lot in between plays and just reviewing what's happened, what we're going to do next. We're constantly thinking, how can we get better in this game?
Can you do it week in, week out, every fucking week to win the fucking league? That's what it's about. We tick them off, we go in each week and we tick each win off. Can we do it this week? Let's fucking go and win the fucking league, alright? Come on, so let's squeeze. Ready? Two, three, squeeze!
Roger Gemmins with a nice high ball now just in front of us. It will be hotly contested by all involved, and it seems to be it's that number five again, Barney Langton, with the lovely firm grip with the high ball, and it's worked its way out into the back line and Met running a very effective attacking play, and Jake Thomas seems to have found himself on the right wing. He's going to slide in for the first try of the game. A lovely bit of interchange play there from the Cardiff Met backs. A beautiful training ground set piece that has been pulled off superbly here for the first score in the game. We find ourselves Cardiff Met 5, Nottingham 0.
That's a great pass. That's an absolute belter of a pass.
Brandon Harvey, the USA Eagles under-20s captain, but it's worked out to Bowden on the wing, back to Westwood, a lovely bit of interchange play there, and Westwood will dive into the left-hand corner for Met's second try of the game.
More like it. For me, listen up now, this is the most important point. We've given away two cheap penalties, which cost us territory, and one of them was 3 points. That is the only way they are going to get territory against us.
And he is Met in midfield. Met will have to clean this up quite quickly. There wasn't much support for him, but Roderick Evans is on that far side of the pitch. He's found Langton, who's found Ivanisevic, who's bitten back in field. He's rollicking away. He's brought down just 5 metres out from the Nottingham try line. Nottingham under severe pressure now after finding themselves around the halfway mark at the pitch. They were 5 metres out from their own line, but a knock-on at the base of the ruck by Cardiff Met means they hand possession back to the University of Nottingham. It was a very clean line-out take there by Cardiff Met, who have set up a strong driving more. They're getting closer and closer to that try line. They are over. And Cardiff Met have another score in this game. That's their third try. They are closer to that crucial bonus point in this match.
Bonus points the next
Tyler
stage
Oldie
now. Bonus points
the
next stage.
Adding to his own
three tries.
Cardiff Met line-out comes in. The driving maul has started. It's motoring forwards towards that Nottingham try line. And Ewan Guy is over for Cardiff Met. The archers are running riot here at Kincoid campus.
Well done, Martha. Well done. Good. Well done. Good goal up. Well done, bud.
So at Nottingham, we're new. Obviously new to BUCS Super Rugby. And the intention was, you know, let's go out there and really bring a degree of physicality that Nottingham haven't sort of witnessed yet. And, you know, on top of the sort of the crowd and potentially, not the hostility, but the high level of atmosphere within the ground, all of that sort of, you know, almost manifested itself in the victory.
Ever since I was born, I was just like straight into rugby, especially my father used to play for Tonga and Ospreys, a few other teams. So like ever since I was a kid, just like chucked the rugby ball in my hand, just playing around, and then obviously watching his games, and a lot of other family play a lot of rugby because it's quite in the Tongan culture, it's very big. Big sport over there, a lot of people play it. So yeah, just ever since I've grown up, just been in a rugby house. So it's just grown up into it, really.
I started off playing league for a team called Violent Sharks back in Warrington, where I was from. And I played there, started there when I was 5 years old, played for 4 years up until under nines, and then made the transition to union because before under nines you can't do contact, but that's boring. So made the switch to under nines, and yeah, never looked back since.
So which game are you looking forward to most this week?
For me, it's got to be the first ever BUCS Super Rugby game at King's Home, the home of Gloucester, where Hartbury will host Cardiff Met.
Absolutely, although the weather forecast isn't looking great, it could be a rough one.
Okay, we won't be long in here. We've done a lot of the messaging already this week. Just from my point of view, you've been out there watching a bit of the girls' game now in terms of the conditions. We're going to have to judge that as the game goes through, but it might be a day where, you know, field position playing without the ball at times might be beneficial. So let's just think about that in terms of our overall game plan. We talked Monday about how we, the last 2 weeks, been a bit of a buzz about the camp. The buzz has come from doing all the shitty things well, from working hard, from playing in good areas, from reloading an attack, from reloading defence, getting off the line, doing all the stuff that's going to make the difference tonight. And that, I promise you, has been the difference. If you do that again tonight, we win the game. If you outwork your opposite number, if you do all the shitty things well, we'll win this tonight. I've got no doubt in it.
Small fucking victories, we fucking beat them, we fucking silence them straight away. Just remember, they don't want to fucking be here, we fucking thriving this weather, right? Listen, there's only one fucking thing that's here for you today. A man test! Who's fucking got it in them to go from 1 minute to fucking 80? Who's got it? That one is the fucking game and that is it. Nothing else to me. Who's a fucking man? Squeeze on me,
come on,
yeah?
Come on.
Ready? Two, three, squeeze!
Come on, boys.
Go!
Let's fucking go, yeah? Everyone, first place!
Go!
Come on, mate. Come on, boys. Ball approaching 5 minutes, another good carry. Bertie Taylor's there. Oh, and Hartbury have strayed offside. Now Cardiff Met have got to come away with something from this visit. That's Ewan Guy right under the sticks. First venture into the 22. Close to the line, short of the line. But surely it's a matter of time until Cardiff Met open the scoring. Another advantage. Matt Hillary concedes the penalty. Joe Cowell's over.
Short, fellas.
Oh, the referee says short. I think he got there, but Met's still going. They are there this time. Relentless from Cardiff Met. The forward pack going to work. It is 5 points under the sticks. And the visitors lead. Centre partner for Joe Westwood today. Him and Bingo Ivanisevic have got
silly
comfortable, but
cut out, please.
Bingo's injured a toe, so David Chiuetti comes in for the first time at 12 this season, and Hartbury go in search of their first try of the match. It's been a great response from them since going seven down, and here they are, 7 metres short, with the ball in the maul, and a few backs adding their weight too. Josiah Edwards Giroux there is at the back. Number 14, marching towards the line here, Hartbury. This is looking good for the team in red. It's a penalty try. Referee goes under the sticks. And Hartbury lead for the first time. Well, both kickers have been unsuccessful with one penalty, but this one is in the balance as the teams jog to the sheds. Cardiff Met opened the scoring, and then Hartbury went on somewhat of a rampage. They've spent a lot of time in the Met 22, but they've only got a 6-point lead to show for it. At half time here, it's Hartbury 13, Cardiff Met 7. Minutes of the second half gone. 1 point in the game. Wickham gathers the line out. Connor Chapman there at the back. Rory Morgan strolls in. They miss out Tuetti. Lovely ball, lovely line. Joe Westwood searching for first phase play. And Westwood shows a clean pair of heels. Cardiff Met 19, Hartbury 13.
Yes, Wednesday!
Great chance here for Met.
Tuesday.
Looking for the bonus point. And there is Joe Westwood. Oh, he reaches and scores. It's first phase for the 13 again. Is that the bonus point?
Great finish.
Okay, but we're not sure, so we're giving it a try.
Joe Westwood, what a finish. And Hartbury back into the 22, they've got an advantage too. Is there a twist in the tail here at King's Home as Liam LaRue comes on to the ball? And it goes from Price. Matt Hillary goes to the open side. This time he's met by Ewan Guy. Oh, he's dropped the ball. Oh, no, he hasn't. It's been given. Oh, Matt Hillary gets the try. Referee's decision is final. Hartbury within touching distance. It's going to be so close, but so far for the team in red.
get through it. Trust your process.